my name is Danny. I'm one of the seniors working on the combo counter project for the summer of 2020. I'm going to show you how to set up the development environment for combo counter to continue working on it. We're going to install two things today. We're going to install Visual Studio either 2019 or 2017 and the MySQL Community Edition. We're going to start with Visual Studio. I'm going to download 2019. If you already have 2019 or 2017 installed, feel free to continue using that. What we have here, going to the Microsoft download page, and downloading the Visual Studio 2019. I already have it downloaded, so we don't have to waste time downloading it again. Just gonna open it up. Yes. And then continue with the install. It's gonna probably take quite a while. Alright, so once we're here and it's asking us what we want to install, we want to make sure that we install the .NET desktop environment, because that's what Combo Counter is written in. It's written in C# using the .NET framework. Specifically here, it's perfect that we have this check, because it's a .NET 4.6.1. So we're gonna go ahead and install. Alright, we got Visual Studio starting up now. Got it already installed. Just gotta set up a few things. And there we go. Looks like we're ready to go with the setup. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and install MySQL. So for MySQL, you want to go ahead and look for the MySQL Community Edition. You want to go ahead and go for the MySQL Community Edition and use the MySQL installer for Windows. Again, I to save time, I already downloaded this, have it ready to go. I'm just going to go ahead and get started. Alright, so we're here in the installer. It's asking us what kind of setup we want. Since we're developers, we want to get the developer default. That's going to give us all the things we need. The server itself, the workbench, is going to let us import our data, and then the connectors for .NET, so that we can connect to it from the program. It says I already have it here, because I already had it installed previously. That's okay. We don't really need these, so we don't really need to worry about that. And then we're gonna go ahead and hit execute, so we can start going ahead and installing. So it looks like everything is all set up and installed. Let's go ahead and hit next. And we're going to go ahead and configure our MySQL Server. So we're not going to do a cluster here, we're just going to do the regular SQL Server. Leave all this standard with TCP/IP. We're going to go ahead and use the strong password encryption. And then we're going to set our root password. Make sure to do make the password whatever you'd like. Make sure you remember it. All right. So you want to start do MySQL as a service. So do all this standard and execute so it can start doing it. Awesome. Looks like we're all set. We're just going to continue. Go ahead and enter that password that you entered in earlier. Go ahead and set up. Just finished our installation, we're going to go ahead and start up MySQL Workbench so we can set up the databases. Alright, we're going to go ahead and go into our local instance. So I already have the database in here, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of it so we can start fresh. So we're going to go to import the data. We're going to provide a .sql file so that it'll have some sample data and some and the database schema are already all set up. So we're going to go ahead into server, data import. Going to do import from self-contained file. Go ahead and navigate to where I have that file. So see comboCounter.sql. The file already contains the schema, so we don't have to worry about this. Okay, we're going to go ahead and hit start import. Should tell you import completed. We're going to go ahead and hit refresh here, and we should see it appear right here. If you want to go ahead and test that, you can do select star from user settings, for example. Run it, and we can see all our data has been imported correctly, and we have data for all of our columns. So our MySQL our MySQL server is already all set up. So we just have to set up the Combo Counter project. So we're gonna go ahead and open up Visual Studio again. 2019 or 2017 if that's the one you have installed. We're gonna open a project or solution. It all depends on where you have your project set up. Mine is in source repos combo counter. We're gonna open up the solution. See everything that we have going on here in the project. Something we do have to set up here in the project properties is in the debug window. We want to change the working directory to set it to just this combo counter folder, the one that has all these folders, the classes, custom controls. We want to set it to this folder, so that way it knows where the sound effects are and where the fonts are. Alright, last thing that we want to do is we want to go to the database connection class and set up what our database is called. So in my example, it's in the localhost. For everybody, it's going to be the same. The database, if you follow the scheme and didn't rename it, it should still be combo_counter. What might change is the user ID and the password. Mine, for example, is root, not very complicated, but you can set yours to whatever your password is, and you should be ready to run. Alright, and we get the login screen. Perfect. Let's go ahead and exit out of that. So, moving on to maintenance. How to maintain Combo Counter. So, in terms of the user interface, we have created some custom classes which help us to use our font and theme manager to add custom fonts and apply a global theme to the entire program. If you want, we can see the font and the theme manager here. The font manager just grabs fonts from the resources.resx here and has a static instance with all these methods to get a specific type of font for whatever specific object that we want to create. And the theme manager has a bunch of static methods for retrieving whatever color is necessary for the current theme. And these controls, they have they're for pretty much any need. I'm sure we didn't think of every need of a control that you could have. But these controls, they inherit from the label class. So if, for example, on this page, the combo score control page, if we wanted to go ahead and add another label right here, we could go ahead and just add, for example, just like a small info. We just want it small. And we can go ahead and just drag that in, and it'll automatically grab the correct font and the correct color that it should be. Pretty simple. So the way it knows the current theme is by going to the user manager. So the user manager has static members, which you can retrieve and set using getters and setters, which hold all the values that a user should have. It also has an instance of a struct called the user settings, which is just an encapsulation of all the user settings, just to be able to pass that around easily. The way pages are added to the main page. So right now, the pages right now are being held in this dictionary on the main page. So the pages are being held right here on this in this dictionary of pages. We do this so that it's easy to individually grab a page or in the case of wanting to change the theme, it's easy to get access to all the pages at the same time. So adding a new page is fairly simple. We have this enum which has an entry in the enum for each page. So when a button is clicked on the home screen, it fires this event. It fires an event called on page selected. On option clicked, when a new option is clicked on the home screen, the on option clicked event is fired, which calls this method, and with this argument the class to call, which basically accesses the for each one of these, it accesses the dictionary with the name of the combo, and then if it doesn't exist, it adds a new instance of the page, and if it does, it just loads that page. It's pretty simple. The last thing is we saw earlier the database connection. The database connection, it's a singleton class. Has a public static get instance method and a private constructor. We want a whole bunch of instances of the database that could waste a lot of resources. All the methods for accessing the database are held in this class. Updating user settings, for example, or adding new retrieving user settings. They're all contained in here and is managed by this class. I think that's what. There's one more thing to note: all of the pages that to be able to hold all the pages in that dictionary, we have this sort of abstract class. Not really, because it has these default methods. But this class that all of the pages inherit from, so that this way that we can keep them all in the same container and they're all the same type, and that we can add on these methods, so that when the main page removes or adds a new page to be displayed, the sub page knows about it, and it also knows when the pages are, when the whole application is going to exit, so that any resources that it needs, or any threads that it's managing, it can go ahead and turn those off before the program exits to prevent a crash. I believe that's about all you need to know to maintain the project. To whoever the future developers are, I wish you good luck. Hope you enjoy working on this project. Thank you.